This is our digital biotensiometer Colin Euro Plus. I would like to show you the kit content. It's been supplied in this bag. It's a thick padded bag with foam packing so that nothing will happen if you are carrying it accidentally. If even falls down, the unit will not get damaged. So you will have the product name and the serial number on the front. And if you open it, you can see the kit content. We will be giving 25 pieces of monofilament in one box, one USB connecting cable, that is for connecting the device to the computer through USB, one power cable for connecting the device to the power supply, 230 volts. We also supply devices with different voltages for different countries, so that we are supplying. This does not have a battery. It needs to work on the 230 volts or any other AC voltage. And this is the vibration probe. Okay. So this has to be used for testing the vibration at different locations. This is the device, okay, and it is also supplied with a detailed user manual. You will have a detailed user manual with all the connectivity description, and this will have two fuses inside. In addition to that, we are giving two more fuses, so the fuses are pinned to the manual. Okay, so this is the total kit content. Now we will see what is available in the device, the different controls, how to connect it, how to test it, and then how to test on a patient with software, with Bluetooth, everything we can see. So I forgot to inform you one special features in this. This has got, apart from the USB connectivity, it also has got a Bluetooth connectivity, so that you can connect it to a computer which has got a Bluetooth. So the distance between the computer and the device can be more. You can keep up to a distance of 15 feet if it is an open room, and you don't need any physical wire connection between the device and the computer. That's the advantage. This will also have an Android support, so Android mobiles, tabs can also be connected with this. So that's the advantage of this. So you can use Windows and also Android. So let's see the other operations. So this is our digital biotensiometer Colin Euro Plus. It is Colin Euro Plus. This is our newer model. Already I have shown you the packaging with the packed condition. I removed all the packings. So it will come with the main unit, the Colin Euro Plus, and then the vibration probe and USB cable, and then the mains cable, and then user manual with software CD. This, unlike our other models, this has got an additional feature. The computer connectivity can be through USB cable or through a Bluetooth cable. Before going into that, I will explain the controls. You have a control here. It's a rotating control. That is for increasing the voltage of the vibration. So as you increase the intensity of the vibration in this tip, it increases. The range is between 0 and 50 volt. And you have a display here to display the voltage in numbers. And you have an off switch. You have a socket for connecting the vibration probe. On the back side, you will see the main socket for connecting the mains cord. You can connect the mains cord, and below it is the fuse. You can see here and the symbol is also there. With the screwdriver you can just pull it out, then you will see two fuses. One is exposed, which is being used, and there will be one more fuse which is hidden, that is in the standby. So two fuses are here. Along with this, we also give two more fuses. They are actually kept it in the user manual. And you can here see a socket for USB cable. So you can connect the USB cable. And on the top you will see a switch. One side is written as Bluetooth, the other side is written as USB. Okay. So if you are using in USB, you can see the switch, put it in USB mode, then you can connect the USB cable and then you can operate it. And if you are putting it on this side towards the Bluetooth, then you can, without connecting the wire between the device and the laptop, you can work through Bluetooth. So that's the advantage. The Bluetooth is an advantage. It has got a range of 10 to 15 feet if it is in an open area. So if your PC, your laptop is little away, then you can comfortably, you can do the testing with the device in a different location, subject to 10 to 15 feet. So these are the few features. First I will put it in USB mode and I will do the demonstration, and then I will change it to Bluetooth, and then I will show you, because we need to pair, like a mobile, if you are connecting a Bluetooth headphone, we need to pair the headphone. The same way, when you are connecting with a Bluetooth the device, we need to pair the device with the laptop. So I will show you. It's a similar way. I will show you how to pair the device, and then we do the testing. Okay. So now it is in USB. So I will connect the rest of the cables. So I will connect the power cable. So I will connect the USB. And I will also connect the vibration probe. It's a screw type. Just fix it and then tight it. Do not over tight it. Okay. Now it's ready. I'm switching it on. You can see it says DFC. That means Dabric Foot Care, and then 00. Before switching on, see that the knob is in the counterclockwise 0 position. Do not switch. Okay. Like this 48. Do not switch off and switch off with a higher voltage. Okay, sometimes because it's a load, because of high load, sometimes you may get the fuse might blow. Okay, so keep it at 0, switch it on, then you slowly increase the number. As you increase the number, you will get the value here, and you will get a vibration proportional to this number. As you said, the range is between 0 and 50 volts. Okay, so this number is the value. Based on the number, we can interpret the data. Okay, there are two ways of interpreting the data. Some of the doctors say that 25 and less are normal, beyond 25 abnormal. There is one more segment they say. Up to 15 is normal. Most of the doctors are using this. Up to 15 it is normal. 16 to 20 it is mild. 21 to 25 moderate. Beyond 25 severe or abnormal. In any case, everybody accept that beyond 25 is abnormal. So if a person, the value goes beyond 25, then his foot is classified as high risk foot. Has to be taken care properly. So this is a simple test. Now I will demonstrate how it can be connected to a computer, and it is going to be tested on the patients in clearly. Okay. So it detects for the communication. So you can see automatically it detects, unlike our other models. We don't have to select the port for communicating between the device and the laptop. So it says Polyneuro Plus connected and COM5, and you can also see the USB symbol. So that means the device is connected to the laptop using the USB cable, not the Bluetooth. Okay. If it is connected through Bluetooth, then you will get the Bluetooth symbol. Okay. That is an indication. So this is a single page report generation software. Before you do the regular test, first time when you are installing, we need to set certain points. So I will explain about the application setting and hospital setting. These two are one time application, and then for doing a regular test it is not required. First I will go into application setting. The first is interpretation on off. Based on the reference values, the system itself detects whether the patient has normal or mild loss of vibration perception, moderate, severe. So based on that, you can give a report, automatic report. Suppose if you do not want this, and then you can switch it off. When you switch it off, then it will just give you the average value and no interpretation is done by the system. And second is automatic ID generation. By default, it is usually on. Most of the hospital, corporate hospitals, they follow unique patient IDs. For every patient, they will have an ID, so that it is easy for getting the data seamlessly. But small clinics and many other centers, they do not have unique patient IDs, and those people, when they start recording it, without knowingly or unknowingly, what they do is they keep on typing the same serial number for every patient. Okay, and then later on it will be a problem, because hundreds of patients will be having a single ID. To avoid that, so the moment you select automatic ID on, by default it is on. So based on the time and date, the software generates its own ID. So any point of time you will not have any clash in the ID. So but for now demonstration purpose I will make it on. Okay, so off actually. So ID is turned off, so that means I have to enter the ID. The system will not generate ID. Email settings, suppose if you want to send the email, you can send the email. So for that we need to have a sender's email data. It presently it supports only the Gmail. Future when we upgrade, automatically the software will be upgraded for the other mail handlers. So you can type the email ID and put that particular password here. Automatically it will save, and then you can share the data by email. Backup. Suppose you feel that your laptop needs to be serviced or some issues, so in that case you want to take all the data. Or maybe after 5 years you feel that the number of data are more, you want to have a backup. So then you can click backup, and then it will ask for a location. If you put a pen drive, then you select the pen drive, and then you give a name, and then automatically it sends the data outside as a backup. Restore. So if you want to bring a data from external source, then you put the external source or even the internal source. You select restore, then it will ask you, because sometimes when you are restoring it, the existing data in the system might get corrupted. So when you say yes, then it again asks for the location. Once you point the location correctly, then the data will be restored in the system. Interpretation rule. So these are the interpretation rules. And if you want, you can change the rules and you can save. So once you have the rule, based on the rule, interpretation is normal, mild, like that. And if you want, you can change the wordings also. It is up to the user. Once you change, then you save. It will have that value. Application title. Okay, this we are having as digital biophysical study for DPN. If you want, you can change it to vibration perception study or whatever way you want. You can change it and save, then it will come on the header of the report. Okay, we have completed everything, and then now the hospital setting. This is for mainly for generating the letterhead for the hospital, because since they are using plain A4 size paper, then you can have this. Suppose you are going to have a printed letterhead, then you can switch off this. Okay, otherwise, so select header by default, our name will be there. Suppose we are going to have printed one, then you can select everything and remove everything, then it will not print it overwrite on the letterhead. If you are using a plain paper, then you can create your address details. So I will say Royal and then the address you can change it. The font can be changed. You can see here they have the font. I can change it to a different font, and then the font size. Okay, you can see it is changed. If you want bigger one, then I can. So can do the maximum, and if you want change the color, I can change it. So right now it is in violet, so I will make it dark blue. So automatically it is changed. So like that, every line, the color, the font, the size can be changed. Once you do this, if you want to see how it look like, then you can see the header. So this is the A4 size. You can see a line. In between the line, you will have the header. In between this, you will have a footer. Actually, the footers are permanent. It will be generated by the software. You cannot modify, it's fixed. Only the header. Either you can remove that, or you can edit and you can have your own header. Then close this. Okay, if you want, you can add logo. You can point the logo point. Now I am putting our logo. It will either ask for BMP, bitmap, or JPG file actually. So I select JPG. Okay. So it's loaded. Okay. If you want to see how it look like, then you can see the header preview. You can see here the logo and then the name. I have not changed it. Okay, I can change it to Royal Hospital. And then save and exit. Okay. So now it is changed. Then comes the consultant. Okay, you don't have to type the consultant name. If it is a single owner hospital, then we can type the name. Already doctor is prefixed. You can add a new, and then I can say here Kumar. Either if you have first name, last name, you can type it. Otherwise, you can have name at the initial. Initial should be on the right side. And then specialization, I can say consultant. Save. Okay, you can add one more. Have as many. If it is a corporate clinic hospital, definitely there will be more than five consultants will be there. You can have all their name, so you can select in the name in the testing page. Okay. So then referral,
for some time you may get a frequent referral from some external source, hospital, small clinics or hospitals. And if you want their name to come, then you can, same way you can add, you can have multiple names. So I'm not adding anything. Examiner, that's a technician. Because some hospital insists the technician name to come on the report, because many times there will be 2-3 technicians. So morning one person will be there, evening one more person will be there. So to have an accountability, they would like to have the technician name. So in that case, you can add and then you can write the name. Okay. So you can again add up multiple names. And you want the technician name to come or not, visibility on the report. Okay, it is now default is showing the name on the report. Suppose if you do not want to find his name on the report, then you can hide it. So now I have done all the testing, I mean the basic settings. Now these are all one time setting, we don't have to change anything. Now we can straight away go for the test, actual test. Whenever a patient comes for the first time, we select new. Suppose the same patient coming after 3 months for entering the test, you have to go for the old. Edit is useful for editing the name and editing some data also. Suppose after taking a test, you feel that you have taken it wrongly, the numbers are wrong, if you want to edit, you cannot do a manual edit. You can only connect the machine and then do an actual test one more time, then you can capture. Not allow the number to be changed manually. Suppose if the daily number is 10, you want to edit a particular spot, instead of 10 you want to have 20, it will not allow you. You have to connect the machine and then capture the data. Either one point or multiple points, you can redo the test here. That is for edit purpose. Delete for deleting the records. Suppose you want to delete some records of the patient, you can delete. Report, after doing a test, you want to see the report of the patient, then you can use the report. I will show you once I test it. I don't know that I have a data. Okay, I have a data here. So once I click report, then it will display here all the names. But since I have only one, only one name is here actually. So I select test. Okay. The moment then it gives you, ask for the ID. You can, it shows ID. So sometimes for the same name, you may have multiple patients. Like in South India, Ramaswamy, if you take, that's a common name. So there may be many Ramaswamy, Santosh. There are some common names available. So once you select the name, then you will have multiple IDs. So if you, since you are following unique ID, then you can select the ID number here actually. Then you will see the dates. So this is being only one test, that particular date is there. If a patient has come for many times and then all the data will be here, then you can select a particular data. Now this particular data is selected, for this particular date interpretation is here, the values are here. Okay, so you can see the numbers. So if you want, you can take a print or you can just exit actually. This is for reviewing the older patient, whatever recording you have already done for reviewing purpose, this is available. So you can click multiple, if it is multiple names, multiple dates, you can click and then those dates data will come here. Okay, so I'm exiting. Okay, on this side of everything is over, and user manual, you will have a complete PDF user manual here. Here you can see screening. Screening is to start the process, and then monofilament, okay, for testing the monofilament, and you are saving the data, seeing, previewing both the recorded output. Export, you can send the data, you can export it. Email, you can send the, suppose you want to get some opinion or you want to share it with somebody else, then you can email, you can also delete here. Refresh and connect. refresh actually while you are doing a test, power goes off. That means naturally the device, laptop, you have a battery, but whereas the device, the BIOS meter does not have a battery. So naturally it will get switched off, and when you again switch it on with the power, then the connection may not come because it is a break in the connection. So in that situation, you can just click refresh, automatically the connection is established. Even after that, if you are not able to get, you please press connect, then it will get connected. And see the number, vibration volt 0, so that will be live. You will get the numbers in this. Now I am changing them from the machine, you can see. So as you change in the machine, the same number whatever is displayed in the machine will be displaying it in the software. So you don't have to see the machine what is the value. In the software itself, you can able to find out the numbers. So this is the complete description about the individual menus. Now we will do it on a patient and then see how it is working. We will do a complete measurement of biophysiometry using the software. So now we have the PolyNeuroPlus reporter and goes into the main screen. So if you see on the right side corner, top corner, you have a message PolyNeuroPlus connected and then some COM30 connected. Below that you have a USB symbol. Since I have connected through a USB cable, I have this selection. And if you want to connect it through Bluetooth, you have to change a switch on the back of the PolyNeuroPlus device from USB to Bluetooth. So you can toggle between USB and Bluetooth. Once you change to Bluetooth, then it will work on Bluetooth. So at that time you will have a Bluetooth symbol, okay, instead of the USB symbol. But when you are connecting for the first time, you may have to pair the device with a laptop or a desktop, just like any other Bluetooth device, like Bluetooth speaker or a Bluetooth headphone. But once you do that, then subsequent times when you are operating it, automatically it will connect it to through you Bluetooth. Since the patient is coming for the first time, so I am clicking new, then selecting the patient name Santosh, and then ID I have to type in PFCI 0010, and age of the patient, okay. And then sex we have to select. You can see it also gives you the indication, select patient gender. For every menu you will have, see now it says consultant doctor name, okay. So if it is single owner hospital, then only one name will come because they have typed only one name. If it is a big hospital, when you have more than one consultant, then we can key in all their names in the setup. Then you can then select whoever you want. Automatically their specialization will also come in. Examiner, there is only one examiner, so automatically his name has come. So now we have done all the basic setup, and then we will go into the testing of biophysiometry. So I have to select screening. So I click screening. Then I will see the foot along with all the spots. You can see here, there is a green mark with a tick mark actually. So when there is a green color with a tick, that means all those points will be recorded. Assuming if the patient comes with an amputation, a toe amputation or a midfoot amputation or a forefoot amputation, then we can deselect those areas, because in that case we need not record those areas. But software, we will only always starts with the right toe. If the toe is not there, unless we deselect, it will not allow you to move from the toe. So for this patient, let's assume we are having a toe amputation. So we will not be recording those. So let me say the left foot toe is amputated. So you can see it becomes red now. So the cursor will only start with this point. So whenever you are doing the test, before doing that particular spot, you can deselect and then you can do it. Suppose if you want to do a complete 4 foot amputation, so you can remove this, then the cursor will be here. Then you can start testing from the instep onwards. So it's very simple. Okay, now the cursor is blinking in the right great toe. So we will be start doing the test with the right toe. So now we are going to test 6 on the right foot and then 6 point on the left foot.
As great toe, first metatarsal, third and fifth metatarsal face, instep and heel. The same thing you can see in the software also. It is there actually, all the spots are the same spots. When I do the testing, the probe should not be pressed hard actually. When I press hard, sometimes it might damage the probe and also the output number might slightly change. So gently touch the spots so that you will get the right value. So before doing the test, we need to educate the patient. The patient should understand the feeling of the testing actually. The vibration pattern should be known to the patient, only then they can able to understand the feeling in the foot. So usually we will keep around 25 volt, a little stronger, and then we will test it on the patient's hand, because normally the hands are not much affected, so they can feel the vibration pattern very nicely, so that they can able to pick up from the foot also later on. So I will be testing it on the bony spot. Do you feel vibration?
Yes.
Now?
Yes.
Now?
Yes.
Now?
Yes.
Okay, you should feel the same in the foot. Whenever you feel, you should say yes.
Okay.
So now, having educated, now I will start from 0 volt. As I reduce the knob, the number in the software also is automatically changing. So now it is in 0. Now I should start slowly increasing it, and then starting with the right toe. So I am keep increasing the number, and he will say at one number. Are you getting it?
Yes.
So he is getting at 6. But I am not sure whether the value is correct. So to make sure correct or wrong, the check key is pressed on the probe. When I press check key, the vibration is stopped. I am stopping the vibration now. Do you feel any vibration?
No.
Now?
Yes.
So I removed it, so vibration resumes, so you can able to feel it. So now the value is correct. Then immediately I can say record. So you get a beep sound, and then the number is also recorded in the software automatically.
So you get a beep sound, and then the number is also recorded in the software automatically. Then I move to the third metatarsal head. Then I'm starting from 0 and slowly increasing, and he has to say what number you are
getting.
You are getting it now?
Yes.
Now? Okay. 6 is recorded. Then third metatarsal head. Do you feel it now?
Yes.
Do you feel it now?
No.
So I press check. He is not feeling. How do you feel it?
Yes.
Okay. So the person is a young person, normal. So values seems to be correct. So I will do it on the third metatarsal. Recording it. Do you feel it?
Yes.
Philip?
Yes.
The Philip?
Yes.
So I have completed one foot, then I will be doing it on the other foot. I will go with zero. The Philip now?
No.
Do you feel it now?
Yes.
Do you feel it now?
No.
I press check, so it's not feeling. Do you feel it now?
Yes.
Okay, I got it. Same way, my first moment is awesome. Third. Do you feel it?
Yes.
Do you feel it?
Yes.
Now?
Yes.
So I have completed the one set of reading. Automatically in the software, you see the all the value, all the spots are recorded. Then automatically the average is also made and the interpretation is also done. Because we enable the interpretation. If the interpretation is off, then you will not see the interpretation. Interpretation is here. Normal study, normal study. Okay. So it is done. So we have completed the full test. So the next is save. If you see here, all the other menus are disabled. When I am doing a particular test, these are all not required. So naturally, all the menus are all, okay, they are all deselected. So the only menu available now is save, because I need to save the data. I saved it, data saved. Now we can see the top are disabled, but in the bottom, preview is open, export is open, email is open, and monofilament open. Suppose if I do not want to test monofilament, and if I want to see the preview, then I can see the preview of this. Here I can see here, Royal Hospital with address, with the logo, the patient details, and then the date at which he is coming, and what is the receipt number. Okay, and then the data here you can see, the values, average values, and then the interpretation, and then the doctor name, everything will come here actually. Okay. So this is the testing. So now I want to do monofilament. Okay. Monofilament is a simple test. I will explain about it. So this is the monofilament. There is a nylon filament embedded in a cord, and it has been calibrated to buckle when I apply 10 gram or more pressure. Okay, when I touch it, it will not bend, but when I give a force, then it bends. When it bends, that means you are applying 10 gram. Even if it is little more, that extra force is taken as a bend actually. So effectively the patient will get only 10 gram. Okay. So he has to say, yes, I am feeling it. So if that is the case, then we can find out the protective touch sense, whether they are normal or lost. And again, the spots are the same, 6 spots. So I will start with the right foot. So again, patient should close the eyes. He should not see the testing, and he should say, do you feel it?
Yes.
Where you are feeling it?
Toe.
Toe. Okay. Now I do it in the other spot. First metatarsal. Do you feel it?
Yes.
Do you feel it?
Yes.
Do you feel it?
Yes.
Do you feel it now?
Yes.
Do you feel it?
Yes.
Which spot?
Heel.
Okay. So then, in all the 6 points, he is having the sense. So I'll do it on the left foot. Do you feel it?
Yes.
Now?
Yes.
Now?
Yes.
Now?
Yes.
So the correct testing is, you have to hold it perpendicular to the subject and press and hold for about 1 to 1.5 seconds, then release it. In step?
Yes.
Now do you feel?
Yes.
So he has felt all the 6 points. Okay. So this I need to enter in the software.
So in the software I select the monofilament. Here if you see, by default all the spots are in green. So the indication for the green here, green is present, red means absent, yellow means not recorded. Not recorded means maybe if we remove because of amputation, if you are removing a toe, then that is not recorded, it becomes yellow. So to change this value, just click this spot, now it becomes red. If you again press, it becomes yellow. So this particular person, he felt the sense in all the spots, so I don't have to touch anything here. Suppose if some particular places he has not felt it, so then in those places only I can select. Okay. So now everything is done, and if you want I can write any remarks and then I can save. Let I save. If you want I can take a preview. You can see here you get a tick mark. If it is absent you will get a double X. NR means not recorded. Simple. So I am just coming to the home screen. So if you see here, there's a green mark with a tick. So that means I have completed both VPT and also monofilament. Okay. So suppose I want to see both preview, then I click here. Then I will be seeing here. This is the biosymmetry. And you get here, you can see page number 1, and I am clicking the page number 2, then monofilament study. Okay. Then you can give print. Then you will get 2 pages of printout. And if you want to export this particular patient data, click export, then select the location, then it will export the data. The test. So if I want to do one more time for the same patient, if he is coming after 6 months, so I select the old. Then the names will be displayed, but here only 2 names, but otherwise you will be having many names. It will be difficult to search through the names. So for that we have a search patient here. By name you can search, or by ID you can search. You can type in the name, 4 letters at least, and then you can click it here. You can see here the test is not there, only Santosh is there. So it will identify the name, and then I have it again. If the same name could be that there are many patients, then since I know the ID, I am selecting the ID. Once I select the ID, then I go for screening. So automatically I come to this screen. Now it is ready for test. So the same way as we tested, increasing the voltage and keep it under foot. Okay. So I am, last time we got it around 6. So you are getting the 6 on the screen. He is feeling the vibration, so I get record. Now it is recorded there. Then I am doing it so like that for all the spots, one after another. I am asking and cross checking and then recording the data. So I have completed. Automatically, you can see the interpretation comes. I have to save, data saved, then monofilament, then the same as usual. I have to select, check those spot with the monofilament, ask for this report. So based on that, I can select. Is being a normal, so all are green. So I save, then I can exit. Now it comes to the main screen. You can see here tick mark in both the tests. That means I completed the test. So I can see preview. I can see both tests. So this is VPT and I'm changing it to monofilament. Once I am okay with this, then I can click the print. Then print is done. You will get a colorful. As you see here, you will get a report actually. So that's the repeat patient. Suppose the patient comes, he has to do. Once you have done everything, then you can exit. it comes to the main screen. Always it will show the product name connected and then port. And if it is USB, USB symbol. If it is Bluetooth, you will get the Bluetooth symbol. We talked about reports. Suppose if you want to review some patient input as data, so select a report, then all the patient names will be displayed. So you have to select, type in at least 4 characters and then you search, then you will get the name. Select, and you can see here the ID will be there. If it is many IDs, you have to, with the proper ID, select the ID. And this particular patient has come for 2 days. Okay, since I have tested 2 times now, you are seeing 2 days actually. So I want to see the this particular date. When I click it, I will get the data here and then the interpretation. Then I can take the printout. If I click it, then I will get this data, because both the data are same. There is no change within this foot actually. If the data are different, then you will get a different number here actually. Then you can see preview and then the printout. Okay? Preview both means both monofilament and bifacial meter. If you say only preview, then it is by default only bifacial meter. Okay? Then you can export it or email it, then you can exit. So I have completed the test, full test I have completed. So new, old, reports, we have seen everything actually. So this is the one complete set I have done using USB cable. Okay, now we will see how the data is recorded using Bluetooth. Functionally, the testing method is all same. Okay, the same way you have to increase and decrease the voltage, and you have to keep the probe at the appropriate site and ask for the patient's input, click check key, see whether his values are right or wrong, and then if it is correct, press record. Automatically the data will come. Like that you have to do for all the points.
For connecting the Polyneuro Plus to laptop through Bluetooth, we need to set up the Bluetooth device in the computer. Before that, the switch on the back of Polyneuro Plus should be moved from USB side to Bluetooth side, and then switch on the Polyneuro Plus. So now the Polyneuro Plus is switched on. Now we have to go and select the Bluetooth. So I click the Bluetooth. Okay. Then it show Bluetooth devices. It should be, the Bluetooth should be on. Suppose in case if your Bluetooth is off, then make it on. So only then we can do the next step. So here you can see add Bluetooth or other devices. You click that. Now it says 3 types: Bluetooth, wireless, and anything else. So we need to do Bluetooth. But when you are doing a Bluetooth connectivity with the device, the distance between the devices, the computer, and the Polyneuro Plus should be between 10 and 15 feet. Okay, and if it is an open room, then it will not be any problem. If it is room to room, sometimes the range might come down because of the wall. If it is open room, maximum probably we can go up to 15 feet. We have tested up to 15 feet. So we have to select Bluetooth. Now it will look for a devices which has got a Bluetooth. So it is showing 2 times basically, because earlier it was there paired and then unpaired, and then again I am pairing it, so it is giving. So let me check, only one will get connected. So let me check, probably this will be the correct one. So I am just, otherwise normally for the fresh you will get only one. Yes, this could be the correct. So it is asking for a pin number for enabling the connection. The pin number is PN plus. Okay, P N plus. Okay, then you connect. It will be indicated in the manual usually. So it says it is paired. So what I have selected is correct. So then I just say done. Now you can see here the polynero plus is paired. So once this is paired, then you can straight away go to the icon, double click it, and then it will get connected. So this is the icon. When I click opening, now actually I have activated the polynero icon. So this is the screen, main screen. It has already opened. And if you see on the right side corner, it says polynero plus connected and then COM31 connected. It is similar to the USB one, but instead of USB symbol, now you can see the Bluetooth symbol. So that's the difference. Now it, instead of physically connected by wire, it is connected without wire through Bluetooth. So the device can be kept away for a distance of 10 to 15 feet. Okay, data can be automatically stored like before. So the procedures are same. The application setting, hospital setting, everything we have already seen in the previous recording. So now I will say new. Select some patient. Suresh Kumar. Here earlier I was given selected manual ID, but here I have selected automatic ID. So automatically the system has given an ID. So I'm just keeping it on the edge. It says type patient age. So I'm typing the patient age. Okay. Consultant. We can select referral, examiner, everything we can select, but here actually in this one I have not entered the consultant name. Okay, so I will straight away go for screening. So now we can see the screening mode. Both the foots are displayed with a green background with a tick mark. If you want to remove some point because of an ulcer or because of an amputation, then you can select those points and record the rest of the points. Assuming if you want to remove this particular patient, so I removed it. Assuming he's got an ulcer or an amputated toe, so now the recording is going to happen from first metatarsal head. So it is a similar way. So I have to slowly increase the value in the device, so the patient has to respond at what value he is feeling the vibration. Okay, so in the previous version he was a young person, so he was able to detect at 6 itself. So here we let us simulate some higher value for demonstration purpose. So I am keeping it at say 22. So this is the value the patient is feeling it, vibration. So I am recording. Okay. So once I record, you can see now toe is removed. So automatically it comes under first metatarsal head. So next point I am testing. So this side I will have a little higher value. So I have done all the values. So you can see automatically it says average is 22 and this side average is 29. So based on that it says moderate loss of vibration perception for the right foot and then severe loss of vibration perception for the left foot. Okay, so now I have done the testing VPT using the Bluetooth. So the next point is I have to save. You can see all the other menus are disabled, only save is enabled. So I save it. It says data saved. Now I will do monofilament. Monofilament again. See automatically here we already removed grade 2 in the VPT. So in this also it shows yellow color. Yellow color means not recorded. Not recorded means 2 is not there actually to record. So the rest of the points I check. So I get so this portion is not failing. Okay, on this foot, toe and heel and metatarsal head is not having the sense. So red means no sense, green means sense. So I'm just saving it. Let us save. Going back to home. So now you can see here preview both means I can see VPT and monofilament. Only preview means only VPT. So I select preview both. You can see here toe we have not recorded. It says NR. NR means not recorded. Okay. So I take the rest of the value and the average 22. Here the rest of the value and average 29. When the value is more than 25, automatically it becomes red color and then it gives you left and right the interpretation. So for the monofilament, toe NR not recorded, tick mark present, double X absent. So we selected these two points double X and then this point double X. And then these two points double X and this is double X. So thing is the patient should feel the sense in majority of the spot. So if you take this side, so it is not recorded and majority of them is not having the sense. Here it is also equal. So that means there is a chance that he is having, he has lost the protective touch sensation or he is at risk for losing protective touch sensation. That is only for demonstration purpose. It is not the actual patient data, just for demonstration purpose. If we say print, then it will give the print and we can take color. You will get a print as you see here actually. Okay, so we have done it. So we exit. So if you want to see the same report, same way report, okay. So you can, there are so many names here actually. So Suresh Kumar is the person. So automatically I will be seeing the record. So if he has come multiple times, then you can see all the value. Let's see some other patient has come. Oh, okay, if you take this particular patient, so there are three recordings. Okay, you can see the different values. You can see every test you have different values, so you will see it actually. And if you want, you can take print, you can take the print also. So that's the advantage of this system. Okay, so if you want again repeat the same patient, select old. Okay, and then you have to select the person, so Suresh Kumar. So now I can straight away I can go to screening and do the testing. It's simple. There is no not much difference between USB and Bluetooth. Exactly same. Only thing in Bluetooth you have to have pairing process. Once you do the pairing process, once the device and the laptops are paired, then it is same as USB method. And anytime you can close and open, it will automatically connect with the device. That's all about the Bluetooth operations. Okay, thank you.